Now that we know what ship we need to set sail on and how our pirate works, it is time to finally... Wait, where are you going? Jimmy? Jimmy? Hey, drop that anchor right now! You forgot all about the resources!
Don't I already have those?
You do, but they are far from enough. It is a war zone out there. You will need a good amount of resources before you take off. You can find those in the barrels that are scattered around the outpost. Every single time you spawn on an outpost. That means you got plenty of things you can gather before you head off on the seas. You can divide resources into three different categories. The first category is planks. These are just your average day-to-day planks that you can use to repair your ship when there is a hole. You put these in the planks barrel. The second category is food. There are 5 different kinds of food you can gather on the island. Bananas that will heal 20%, coconuts which will heal 30%, pomegranates that give you 40%, mangoes give you 50%, and pineapples that give 100%. Not once, but twice. Something else you might find among the food category is bait. You can find bait in the barrels on the island, but also by digging the island. You will find grubs by digging the sand, leeches by digging the shorelines, and earthworms you can find on grass and earth. You put all of these in the yellow food barrel. You can organize your barrels and categorize your bait and food separately, but that is optional. It does make grabbing food in a tent situation easier. The last category is balls. Cannonballs! I meant cannonballs! There are 3 different kinds. Plain cannonballs and chain shots, cursed cannonballs, and throwables. If you are playing on a brig or galleon, you can easily divide all of these in a respective barrel. But if you are on the sloop, you will have to divide them among the 2 barrels you have. I usually put my chain shots together with my regular cannonballs and put the curse together with the throwables. It will take the more effort to raid your supplies when it's all across your barrels.
But Michael?
Yes?
How many resources do we need before we take off?
Well, the spawn rate is very variable, but try to get at least 40 planks and 80 cannonballs. As long as you raid the entire island, you should have more than enough supplies. Do make sure you get familiar with the barrel placement, since they will make you become faster at looting and should bring you onto the seas faster each time. Now that you have acquired a whole lot of resources, it is finally time to familiarize yourself with your worthy vessel. On top deck, you will find your mast with sails. Each mast has 2 sets of each of rock to adjust the amount of sails you use to adjust speed, and a pulley to adjust the angle of the sails to catch wind. On top of the main mast, you can find the crow's nest, which has both the bell and the flag box. Make sure you always have a flag on your ship. Just like back in the Spice Trader days, it will help you show where the wind is coming from.
Oh wow, a rat pirate flag!
Oh no, don't touch that! That flag will show everyone in the server where your ship is at. You don't want that as a beginner.
So no cool flag?
No cool flag. Next on top deck is your capstan, which is fancy pirate talk for anchor. If you have it lowered, you will not be able to turn or move. You are not going to touch that thing unless you are starting a new ship, or on an island in stormy weather, or doing an anchor turn as an emergency break before you hit an island, or when you are trying to get a tactical advantage in a battle. So not your own anchor, but theirs. Helm is how you can steer your ship. It is suited with a compass for easy navigation as well. There is a difference in between the helm across the different ships as well. The sloop goes around 1 rotation, the brig 1.5 rotation, and the galleon 2 rotations. You will know your helm is centered when the different looking peg on it is aligned with your mast and makes a little sound. Moving down to the front of your ship, you have your cannons, which will help you attack filthy land scum, sea scum, and regular scum. You can also launch yourself and your pets out of cannons. Very front of your ship, you will find the harpoons, which are used for quick maneuvers.
Nice! Good stuff.
Grabbing loot or resources. Pulling your lazy crew out of the sky. And killing skellies. Which takes absolutely forever, don't even try it. You also have lanterns all across your ship. Make sure these are turned off before you leave. Your visibility at night will be drastically lowered and will also be seen as a sign of not being a total noob. Time to move into the lower decks. You will find your map table down there. It will show you all the islands and perhaps Reaper's items, such as ships with a Reaper's mark, you know, that red flag that we just discussed, Reaper's chest, and active forts of the damned. Another table you find on your ship is the voyage table. The entire crew can put quests on the table to vote on, which can also cancel quests that have already been started. Something to look after for combat are the ammo chests and weapons box. Make sure you know where they are before you start trying to pwn noobs. Your ship will also have three kinds of resource crates. One for planks, two for food, and depending on your ship size, two or three for cannonballs. Next to your food barrels, you will find a stove, which you can use to cook fish, shark, meats, and kraken meat. You can also try cooking your food, but that will leave your ship on fire, and it will also leave a pretty nasty stench. If one of your crew members starts behaving like a jerk, you can vote to lock them in the brig. Eat that, you bogey! Do note that somebody has to have been in the brig for a good couple of minutes before they can get voted out, so take that note in mind when you're about to engage in combat. Also very important, the water barrel, which allows you to grab water quickly in dire situations, such as fire. You also got the grog barrel. If you ever run out of grog, you can still get a lot more. Last but not least, your customizables. There are four different chests you can use to change your loadout. The vanity chest for your appearance, the clothing chest for your clothing, the equipment chest for your equipment, and the pet chest for your pets, if you have them at least. And there you have it! All the tips and tricks to get started on the Sea of Thieves and start raiding that sweet, sweet pirate booty.
Is that really all there is to it?
Yes, sir! Although I do have a feeling that I forgot to talk about something. Well, if it isn't important, I wouldn't have forgotten. Ooh, yeah, PvP.